Oh, me too.
Always been collies and German shepherds.
Oh, I'm the little tiny kind of friend.
Yeah, a lot of Christmas parties and stuff this week.
Three of us.
Three of you? Okay.
Oh, we're back.
I don't think that's big enough.
Okay. Okay.
Get back a little bit.
Don't hurt yourself.
Try to run the ears a little bit.
Everybody else kind of just come in. Okay.
He's right here.
Keep the ribbon held real tight. And on the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Cheeseburger. Here we go. Thank you. We are officially open. Everybody want to buy a window? Yeah, we're taking orders. Yeah, we're taking the fun. Does anybody need a window? Right here. Good job, Tim.
Tell Ryan what he does.
And then on to the trim tables or on the ship. Right side here is the casement line, which I guess everybody's familiar with the difference between a casement and a double hung. Casement has a crank, so it's a single panel that opens, whereas the double hung is two panels. So down here at the end, far end, where the casement panels would get assembled, and then the casement frames to the right, and then they get hung out there as well.
You're going to build a French casement?
French casement. I haven't seen any plans for that yet. I don't know if that's, we haven't talked about that. Just standard left, right, etc.
It's possible.
Frames will get Frank's sub-assembly is here, so he's... One jam is an assembly of the jam, the trim, interior trim, and the vinyl jam liner. So these are built sub-assembly. The sub-assembly goes into the framer where it's all nailed together. And the sash is actually put together down here with your glass, IG unit, and your stiles and rails, and then they're hung out. The sash meets the frame at that green upright stand. The sash are hung in the frame at that point. Then they move on to shipping or the trim tape.
Thank you.
cards go in the ballot, the ballot, the whole ballot goes down. Special colors. We have, I believe, 8 standard colors that we stock for our higher end products. But we offer a lot more colors than any of the special colors we paint here. Right now, we want to offer our customers the highest products, highest on our paint, highest certification, which is 2605. We're not capable of doing that here right now. In the future, we will be able to do that. We will paint those here again, but in the meantime, we probably have to get somebody else to paint them for us. Fabrication, so our saws cut anything, limit up the length, trim dies for notching, put molds in aluminum extrusions, it all happens in the area.
Basically what we've done for these lines up here is with the lean manufacturing process in order, we've shrunk everything down, moved all the machinery closer to where people take less steps. Usually it's only about 3 or 4 steps per station. It minimizes on the waste of time. We've also brought in the cart to put around the workstation so that way everybody's parts are right near them to where that's they grab the part, they put it in the machine, the press, and it's onto another cart and moving on down the line. Basically, we've got 2 different series of double hung windows that come off this. Well, it's going to be 4. There's going to be a builder series wood and a builder series flat. Then there will be a mansion series wood and a mansion series flat. Now, what we've done is all the mansion parts are going to, the sash parts will be on those racks over there. The builders will be over here. All the sash are funneled down into the middle of the line. The framing is all built back on the other side. They meet in the middle, that's where the sash gets hung out and then off the packaging and right to shipping. So it directs the flow. Once we get more up and full running, then we're gonna start timing the workstation to adjust the flow rate to see where we need to adjust people and everything. So that'll help us with the lean a lot more once we get through that. Yeah, like what they're building now is it's a wood product, it's a builder's wood, it's a butyl glaze. It's a butyl here, goes down, you can see it as it gets assembled, the sash goes on down, the frames are done on the other side, they come together, get hung out, and boom. It can be a very fast process once we get this up fully manned. Because you're looking at a very skeleton crew right now doing it. Usually there's a person at every station and it's just about a unit every 3 minutes. They can put roughly 200 to 250 builders units out a day and probably 100 to 150 mansion units out a day. So, and that's just on this line. So we're looking at a minimum of about 300 to 400 units per day off this line. They do the same on the casement line also. So it really starts to pump out pretty fast. Yeah, absolutely. When we've got this place fully staffed, I mean, what we've been doing over the last few months is reorganizing the lines, getting the concept of lean down, and getting the new parts fabricated in the back. I'm sure you guys seen all that back there. That's a complete new window design. So it was a lot of detail going into it, a lot of testing, making sure the parts fit right. So you have quite a time because you end up building prototypes. You go, well, that didn't quite work that way. Let's change it a little bit here, you know, and we think we've got it down to a pretty good fit now, and hopefully be sending some stuff off for testing pretty soon. So, but I'm pretty pleased with the way the guys have all pulled together. You know, really, these guys here are all team leaders. They're actually going to be running their own individual lines and departments. They are in charge of that line.
and they run it. They make sure they control the flow of it. We cut down on supervisors. This place used to have about 12 supervisors, way too many. So now we've got a supervisor for the back, a supervisor for the front. We've empowered the team leaders to run their line, set it up the way they know it runs properly. And everybody's embraced it pretty good, and it seems to be going pretty well so far. We've gotten a lot of good results, a lot of good ideas out of it, you know, because these are the people that worked here before that ran these lines. They know it better than anybody else how it should have been set up. And that's why we did it.